we have to discuss as well as MLA, because we have students of literature. So referencing allows you to acknowledge the contribution of the other writers and the researchers in your work. That basically whenever you are going to write a literature review, introduction, you are having material from the other researchers, from the research articles, books, or the other things. So it also a way to give credit. For example, if you have taken something from me, you have to acknowledge that I have some contribution in your work. It is, you can say, it's one of the ethics or the, it is your moral obligation to acknowledge my work that you have got from my side, and you have written your own work, but my work is also a contribution in your work. So to appreciate, to acknowledge, or to credit, to give credit to the person whose writing or whose intellectual property you have used in your own research article or whatever you are going to write. So when you are taking material from the thesis or the research article of some other person, and that is the published article, when once you have got published, you have got basically that becomes your intellectual property. So when you are having the intellectual property of some other person, at least it is your moral obligation to give credit to that person. So how we can give credit to that person? The question is, when you are using the intellectual property of some other person, so then how you can basically give credit to that person by citing that person? Citation is on the two places, cite while right and at the end of your thesis in the portion of bibliography. So by citing the work of a particular scholar, you acknowledge and respect the intellectual property rights of that researcher. Once you have got published, the whatever you have written, that becomes your intellectual property. And your intellectual property has its own rights. Just like copyrights of them, in the preface of the book or in the initial pages of the book, kya hota hai? Ke usne likha hota hai ki is jo hai वो एक स्टेटमेंट लिखी होती है कि इस किताब क्या कोई हिस्सा कॉपी फोटो कॉपी या पब्लिश उस नहीं किया जा सकता. बेसिकली तो वंस यू हैव गॉट पब्लिकेशन इट बिकम्स योर इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी. सो देन इट्स अ वे टू प्रोवाइड एविडेंस टू सपोर्ट द असर्शंस एंड द क्लेम्स इन योर ओन असाइनमेंट बाय साइटिंग एक्सपर्ट इन योर फील्ड. You are showing your marker that you are aware of the field in which you are operating. So when you are actually, if you are writing a thesis, if you are writing an article in a certain domain of the field or in a certain domain of knowledge, you have to basically gather material from only that domain of knowledge. जैसे कि आप अगर physics पे research article लिख रहे हैं तो उसमें आप बायोलॉजी का पोर्शन नहीं डाल सकते, लेकिन लिंग्विस्टिक्स में आप फिजिक्स वाला पोर्शन भी डाल सकते हैं व्हेन यू आर डूइंग अकूस्टिक एनालिसिस एंड फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द साउंड्स. सो वंस यू हैव डिसाइडेड योर टॉपिक, वंस यू हैव डिसाइडेड योर फील्ड, देन व्हाटएवर द लिटरेचर रिव्यू, व्हाटएवर द थिंग दैट यू आर गोइंग टू इनकॉर्पोरेट इन योर थीसिस और रिसर्च आर्टिकल, यू हैव टू collect material from the remain certain related portion or the related domain of the knowledge. So we are taking when you are writing something, so you have to take the material from the different experts of that particular field. So then referencing should always be accurate. Sometimes when you are doing referencing manually, so there are clear chances of mistakes, where to put comma, where to put full stop, which portion of the reference is going to be italic, how to, where to give a full stop, and all this is a very complicated thing. Manually, ye bahut bada azaab hai, which you are going to face when you have nothing, no software for that. So we are here to solve your problem of referencing. References, it should be accurate. Accurate means it should be very clear and authentic one. The best way to make sure your reference accurately is kept a record of all the sources you used when reading and researching for an assignment. Citation also make your writing more persuasive. जैसे आप ऐसे लिखते हैं और ऐसे में आपको कहा जाता है कि quotations डालें. Why quotation? That makes your argument strong.
Valid.
If you are giving a reference, if you are citing the previous researches, it's basically making your research article or the writing piece of writing persuasive. It will, its value will be increased. So these are two paragraphs, and you are to tell me that which one is the best one, and argumentative, persuasive, and which have the clear arguments. Both have the same, I think. Both are the same, but there is some sort of a difference between them. Referencing. हमारे बच्चे क्या करते हैं? पूरा पैसेज लिख के एंड पे एक रेफरेंस और वो भी गलत.